Lesnar at SummerSlam.
And a standing ovation here tonight in San Antonio for the arrival of the Conqueror. But come SummerSlam, it will be the last time, the last match, last man standing. Lesnar seems to be in a good mood tonight, but wait until SummerSlam.
Well, God bless Texas. With an intro like that, it'd be rude for me to leave my hat on this evening. I'll show you all some manners. Thank you very much. As we just saw, life is good for Roman Reigns. You see, since WrestleMania, Roman's been living high on the hog, flying in private jets, eating like a king. I think there's an old saying, and it came from right here in Texas. Pigs get fat and hogs get slaughtered. Roman Reigns, you're a hog. And I slaughter hogs on my farm every single day. At SummerSlam, the tribal hog is gonna get a country shit kicking to the likes he's never seen.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, what an unpleasant surprise for Lesnar. The face Brock did not want to see. The special counsel for the tribal chief, Paul Heyman. What a great amount of history between these two men. For many years, Heyman was Lesnar's advocate.
Yeah, I assure you, we on the island of relevancy are booing as well. We've gone.
Speaking of hogs,
well, that's not downright Texas neighborly of you.
But
we've gone. Listen, despite our differences, Brock Lesnar does not suck. Ladies and gentlemen,
three little piggies went to town. Oink, oink, oink. Are you gonna say something worthwhile here, Paul?
You know what bothers me? We've gone from the most stupendous WrestleMania of all time to the most barbaric SummerSlam of all time, and that plays right into your hands. The odds-on favorite, if you're a betting man, who are you betting on for SummerSlam in a last man standing match? Brock Lesnar. Why? Because Roman Reigns defined his greatness by athletically beating down, smashing the opposition, pinning them, making them tap out in athletic competition. But we, for 20 years, we defined Brock Lesnar's legacy by annihilating people, by putting them down for good, by taking them out of action, by breaking their necks, by conquering streaks, by ending careers. So if Brock Lesnar has to put Roman Reigns down for the count of 10, that's what Brock Lesnar is going to do. It doesn't matter to Brock Lesnar if he puts Roman Reigns down for 10, or if he's so violent he puts Roman Reigns down for 100. He doesn't care if he sends Roman Reigns to the hospital or if he sends Roman Reigns to the morgue. That's not a man. That's a beast. That's a hog slaughterer. That's an annihilator. That is an avenging badass that wants revenge against my tribal chief. I'm going to give you my word on something. We are approaching 700 days of Roman Reigns as the champion. And Brock Lesnar, this is one streak you will not conquer. Because I will have Roman Reigns ready for you at SummerSlam to put you down. If I have to train Roman Reigns to stick his hand up your ass and pull your heart out through that hole, that is what my tribal chief is going to do to something like you. Did you just say,
go, let's go!
Second.
Mr. Money in the Bank in the house.
Well, up until this point, I'm sure it's been an afterthought for Lesnar, but it is a very real possibility after the brutality of Last Man Standing. Theory will be waiting to cash in.
And Brock looks perplexed at this point.
Brock wisely keeping his eyes on
SummerSlam Theory. Is going to be one of the greatest nights in WWE history. I'm going to take back my United States Championship from Bobby Lashley, and then I'm gonna sit back and watch this match of mass destruction. But you see, after this match, I'm not gonna run down to the ring. I'm gonna walk down to the ring, holding my tie, handing it to the official, cashing in my contract, and either putting my foot on your chest or Roman Reigns' chest, and then the announcer will announce, and the new, youngest, undisputed WWE Universal Champion of the world, Theory.
Well, why don't you come down here right now and let's go?
You know what, Brock? It doesn't matter if you win or Roman Reigns wins, because the way you two are talking about the outcome, it's going to be life-altering. And Mr. Heyman, I have to say, maybe you should listen to Brock Lesnar, because I actually have some footage of my own from this year's Elimination Chamber, where it just shows that Brock Lesnar doesn't give a damn about anybody but himself. He doesn't care about anybody's life but his own. Roll the footage.